Hello, welcome, blessed and highly favored of the Most High God, the Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, to Jesus for All, too, for October 17th, 2024. Here, we will hear daily readings of God's Word, the Bible, the bread of life. For in the book of John, chapter 6, 35, and Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. Our goals, to increase our faith, to please the Heavenly Father, to walk in the abundant life that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ redeemed for us with his blood, death, and resurrection on the cross at Calvary, and to do the works and the greater works that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ said we would do in the book of John, chapter 14, verse 12. Most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these you will do, because I go to my Father. We know from John 1, verse 1 to 2, that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Verse 2, he was in the beginning with God. Verse 3, and all things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made, for in him was life, and the life was the light of men. Verse 14, the Word became flesh, and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. And we know from John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And John 1, verse 12, but as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name. And that would be us, I pray, at Jesus for All, too, in the name of Jesus Christ. The book of John, chapter 15, verse 7 through 8, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so you will be my disciples. In Proverbs, chapter 11, verse 30, the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he who wins souls is wise. The book of Mark, chapter 16, beginning with verse 15, reads, and he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Verse 16, he who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned. 17, and these signs, these are the works, will follow those who believe. In my name they will cast out demons, they will speak with new tongues. 18, they will take up serpents, and if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. For we know that Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6 reads, but without faith it is impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Romans 10, 17, so then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. The book of John, chapter 10, beginning with verse 9. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved, and will go in and out and find pasture. 10. The thief does not come except to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I have come that they may have life, and that they may have it more abundantly. Verse 11. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. And Psalm 23, verse 1. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. John 4:24 reads, God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The word of God, the whole Bible, is progressive revelation from the New Old Testament to the New Testament. As you read all of it, hear all of it, you come to understand who our Heavenly Father, the Lord Jesus, and the Holy Spirit truly are, and the precious gifts that they have given us. John 14, verse 15, if you love me, keep my commandments, and I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may abide with you forever. Verse 17, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans, I will come to you. And John 14, verse 26, but the Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name. Because, as we just read, Jesus prayed that the Father would send him. He will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all things that I said to you. And John 16:13, however, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, He will guide you into all truth, for he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak, and he will tell you things to come. That we require not to consult with mediums, tarot cards, palm readers, mediums, astrology, all these things which are an abomination to our Heavenly Father, by his word, in the name of Jesus Christ, because he has given us the Spirit of Truth, the Holy Spirit, our helper, advocate, comforter, counselor, who will tell us things to come. Amen. Hallelujah. And so the words of life that we shall receive today, October 17th, 2024, are Psalm 21, the Old Testament reading, the book of Ezekiel, chapter 17, verse 1 through chapter 19, verse 14, and the New Testament reading, the book of Luke, chapter 23, verse 1 through 56. The Psalm, the prayer focus, Psalm 36, and the New Testament will be read from the New King James Version of the Bible, copyright 1982 by Thomas Nelson Incorporated, used by permission, all rights reserved. The Old Testament reading will be from the Amplified Version of the Bible, copyright 1954, 1958, 1962, 1964, 1965, and 1987 by the Lockman Foundation. I'd like to thank every listener of Jesus for All Too. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that your faith is increasing, your knowledge of the promises of God, and that you are receiving the grace by the Holy Spirit to walk in those promises and to do the works and the greater works that our Lord and Savior said we would do. I humbly ask in the name of Jesus Christ that you would share Jesus for All Too with another. And as it is the last quarter of 2024, we are asking and hoping to share Jesus for All Too and the Word with at least four people in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless every listener in Jesus' name, and thank you for your support. And now Psalm 21, the theme of Psalm 21, praising God after victory in battle. When God answers our prayers for victory, we must quickly and openly thank him for his help. Amen. And his help will definitely come. Whether you see it with your eyes or not, you know it has come in the name of Jesus Christ. According to Matthew 7, verse 8, everyone who asks receives, everyone who seeks finds, and everyone who knocks, it is open to them, according to the Heavenly Father's will. And now, Psalm 21 at verse 1. The king shall have joy in your strength, O Lord. And in your salvation, how greatly shall he rejoice. You have given him his heart's desire, and have not withheld the request of his lips. Selah. For you meet him with a blessing of goodness. You set a crown of pure gold upon his head. He asked life from you, and you gave it to him, length of days forever and ever. 5. His glory is great in your salvation. Honor and majesty you have placed upon him. For you have made him most blessed forever. You have made him exceedingly glad with your presence. 7. For the king trusts in the Lord, and through the mercy of the Most High he shall not be moved. 8. Your hand will find all your enemies. Your right hand will find those who hate you. 9. You shall make them as fiery oven in the time of your anger. The Lord shall swallow them up in his wrath, and the fire shall devour them. 10. Their offspring you shall destroy from the earth, and their descendants from among the sons of men. 11. For they intended evil against you. They devised a plot which they are not able to perform. 12. Therefore you will make them turn their back. You will make ready your arrows on your string toward their faces. Verse 13 and last. Be exalted, O Lord, in your own strength. We will sing and praise your power. And in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, this word is already blessed as we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, are every of us the hearers. Amen. And now, the book of Ezekiel, chapter 17, and it reads, And the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, put forth a riddle and speak a parable or allegory to the house of Israel. Say, thus says the Lord God, A great eagle, Nebuchadnezzar, with great wings and long pinions, rich in feathers of various colors, came to Lebanon, which is symbolic of Jerusalem, and took the top of the cedar tree. He broke off the toppermost of its young twigs, the young king Jehoiachin, and carried it into a land of trade, which is Babylon. He set it in a city of merchants. 5. He took also of the seedlings of the land, Zedekiah, one of the native royal family, and planted it in fertile soil and a fruitful land. He placed it beside abundant waters and set it as a willow tree to succeed Zedekiah's nephew, Jehoiachin, in Judah as vassal king. 6. And it grew and became a spreadling vine of low, not Davidic, stature, whose branches turned in submission toward him, and its roots remained under and subject to him. The king of Babylon, so it became a vine, and brought forth branches, and shot forth leafy twigs. 7. There was also another great eagle, the Egyptian king, with great wings and many feathers, and behold, its vine, Zedekiah, bent its roots languishingly toward him, and shot forth its branches toward him, away from the beds of its planting, for him to water. 8. Though it was planted in good soil, where water was plentiful for it to produce leaves and to bear fruit, it was transplanted, that it might become a splendid vine. 9. Thus says the Lord God, ask, will it thrive? Will he, the insulted Nebuchadnezzar, not pluck up its roots and strip off its fruit so that all its fresh sprouting leaves will wither? It will not take a strong arm or many people to pluck it up by its roots, totally ending Israel's national existence. 10. Yes, behold, though transplanted, will it prosper? Will it not utterly wither when the east wind touches it? It will wither in the furrows and beds where it sprouted and grew. 11. Moreover, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, 12. Say now to the rebellious house, do you not know and realize that these things, what these things mean? Tell them, behold, the king of Babylon came to Jerusalem and took its king, Jehoiachin, and its princes, and brought them with him to Babylon. Verse 13. And he took one of the royal family, the king's uncle, Zedekiah, and made a covenant with him, putting him under oath. He also took the mighty and chief men of the land, 14, that the kingdom might become low and base and be unable to lift itself up, but that by keeping his, Nebuchadnezzar's covenant, it might stand, 15. But he, Zedekiah, rebelled against him, Nebuchadnezzar, in sending his ambassadors into Egypt, that they might give him horses and much people. Will he prosper? Will he escape who does such things? Can he break the covenant with Babylon and yet escape? 16. As I live, says the Lord God, surely in the place where the king Nebuchadnezzar dwells, who made Zedekiah as vassal king, whose oath Zedekiah despised and whose covenant he broke, even with him in the midst of Babylon shall Zedekiah die. 17. Neither shall Pharaoh with his mighty army and his great company with him in the war, with the Babylonians cast up mounds and build forts to destroy many lives. 18. For Zedekiah despised the oath and broke the covenant, and behold, he had given his hand and yet has done all these things, he shall not escape. 19. Therefore thus says the Lord God, as I live, surely my oath made for me by Nebuchadnezzar that Zedekiah has despised, and my covenant with him that he has broken, I will even bring down on his own head. 20. And I will spread my net over him, and he shall be taken in my snare, and I will bring him to Babylon and will enter into judgment and punishment with him there for his trespass and treason that he has committed against me. 21. And all his fugitives from Judah and all his bands shall fall by the sword, and they shall remain, shall be scattered toward every wind. And you shall know, understand, and realize that I am the Lord. I have spoken it. 22. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will take a twig from the lofty top of the cedar and will set it out. I will crop off from the toppermost of its young twigs a tender one and will plant it upon a mountain high and exalted. 23. On the mountain height of Israel will I plant it, that it may bring forth boughs and bear fruit and be a noble cedar. And under it shall dwell all birds of every feather. In the shade of its branches they shall nestle and find rest. 20. And all the trees of the field shall know, understand, and realize that I, the Lord, have brought low the high tree, have exalted the low tree, have dried up the green tree, and have made the dry tree flourish. I, the Lord, have spoken, and I will do it. Chapter 18. The word of the Lord that came to me again, saying, what do you mean by using this proverb concerning the land of Israel? The fathers have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge. 3. As I live, says the Lord God, you shall not have occasion any more to use this proverb in Israel. Behold, all souls are mine. As the soul of the Father, so also the soul of the Son is mine. The soul that sins, it shall die. Reference Romans chapter 6, verse 23, verse 5. But if a man is uncompromisingly righteous, upright in the right standing with God, and does what is lawful and right, and has not eaten at the idol shrines upon the mountains, nor lifted up his eyes to the idols of the house of Israel, has not defiled his neighbor's wife, nor come near to a woman in her time of impurity, 7, and has not wronged anyone who has restored to the debtor his pledge, has taken nothing by robbery, but has given his bread to the hungry, and has covered the naked with a garment, 8, who does not charge interest or percentage of increase on what he lends in compassion, who withholds his hand from iniquity, who executes true justice between man and man, 9, who has walked in his statutes and kept my ordinances to deal justly, then he is truly righteous. He shall surely live, says the Lord God. 10. If he begets a son who is a robber or a shedder of blood, who does to a brother either of these sins of violence, 11, and leaves undone all of the duties of a righteous man, and has even eaten the food set before idols on the mountains and defiled his neighbor's wife, 12, has wronged the poor and needy, has taken by robbery, has not restored to the debtor his pledge, has lifted up his eyes to idols, has committed abomination, things hateful and exceedingly vile in the eyes of... Verse 13. And has charged interest or percentage of increase on what he has loaned in supposed compassion. Shall he then live? He shall not live. He has done all these abominations. He shall surely die. His blood shall be upon him. 14. But if this wicked man begets a son who sees all the sins which his father has committed, and considers and fears God, and does not do like his father... Verse 15, who has not eaten food set before idols upon the mountains, nor has lifted up his eyes to the idols of the house of Israel, has not defiled his neighbor's wife, 16, nor wronged anyone, nor has taken anything in pledge, nor has taken by robbery, but has given his bread to the hungry, and has covered the naked with a garment, 17, who has withdrawn his hand from oppressing the poor, who has not received interest or increase from the needy, but has exalted his ordinances, and has walked in my statutes, he shall not die for the iniquity of his father. He shall surely live. 18, as for his father, because he cruelly oppressed, robbed his brother, and did not that which is not good, and did that which is not good among his people, behold, he shall die for his iniquity and guilt. 19. Yet do you say, why does not the son bear the iniquity of the father? When the son has done that which is lawful and right, and has kept all my statutes and has done them, he shall surely live. 20. The soul that sins, it is the one that shall die. The son shall not bear and be punished for the iniquity of the father, neither shall the father bear and be punished for the iniquity of the son. The righteous of the righteous shall be upon him only, and the wickedness of the wicked shall be upon the wicked only. 21. But if the wicked man turns from all his sins that he has committed and keeps all his statutes and does that which is lawful and right, he shall not die. 22. None of his transgressions which he has committed shall be remembered against him, for his righteousness which he has executed, for his moral and spiritual rectitude in every area and relation, he shall live. 23. Have I any pleasure in the death of the wicked, says the Lord, and not rather that he should turn from his evil way and return to his God and live? 24. But if the righteous man turns away from his righteousness and commits iniquity, and does according to all the abominations that the wicked man does, shall he live? None of his righteous deeds which he has done shall be remembered. In his trespass that he has trespassed, and in his sin that he has sinned, in them shall he die. Yet, 25, yet you say, the way of the Lord is not fair and just. How now, O house of Israel? Is not my way fair and just? Are not your ways unfair and unjust? 26, when a righteous man turns away from his righteousness and commits iniquity and dies in his sin for his iniquity that he has done, he shall die. Verse 27, again, when the wicked man turns away from his wickedness which he has committed and does that which is lawful and right, he shall save his life. 28, because he considers and turns away from all his transgressions, which he has committed, he shall surely live, he shall not die. 29, yet says the house of Israel, the way of the Lord is not fair and just. O house of Israel, are not my ways fair and just? Are not your ways unfair and unjust? 30, therefore I will judge you, O house of Israel, everyone according to his ways, says the Lord God. Repent and turn from all your transgressions, lest iniquity be your ruin, and so shall they not be a stumbling block to you. Matthew 3:2 and Revelation 2:5. Verse 31, cast away from you all your transgressions by which you have transgressed against me, and make you a new mind and heart and a new spirit. For why will you die, O house of Israel? Ephesians 4:22-23. Verse 32, for I have no pleasure in the death of him who dies, says the Lord God. Therefore turn, be converted, and live. Chapter 19. Moreover, take up a lamentation for the princes of Israel, and say, what a lioness was your mother, Jerusalem, Judah. She couched among lions in the midst of the young lions. She nourished her cubs. 3. And she, the royal mother city, brought up one of her cubs, Jehoahaz. He became a young lion, and he learned to catch the prey. He devoured men. 4. The nations also heard of him. He was taken in their pit, and they brought him with hooks to the land of Egypt. 5. Now when she had waited, she saw her hope was lost. Then she took another of her cubs, Jehoiachin, and made him a young lion. 6. And he, Jehoiachin, went up and down among the lions. He became a young lion and learned to catch prey, and he devoured men. 7. And he knew and ravaged their strongholds, and he laid waste their cities. And the land was appalled, and all who were in it, by the noise of his roaring. 8. Then the nation set against the king on every side from the provinces, and they spread their net over him, Jehoiachin. He was taken in their pit. Verse 9. With hooks they put him in a cage and brought him to the king of Babylon. They brought him into custody and put him in strongholds, that his voice should no more be heard among the mountains of Israel. 10. Your mother, the mother city Jerusalem, was like a vine, like you, Zedekiah, and in your blood planted by the waters, it was fruitful and full of branches by reason of abundant water. 11. And it had strong rods for the scepters of those who bore rule, and its height was exalted among the thick branches and into the clouds. And it was seen in its heights among the multitude of its branches, and was conspicuous. 12. But the vine was plucked up in God's wrath by his agent, the Babylonian king, and it was cast down to the ground. The east wind dried up its fruit. Its strong rods were broken off and withered. The fire of God's judgment consumed them. 13. And now it is transplanted in the wilderness, in a dry and thirsty land, also known as Babylon. Verse 14. And fire went out of a rod, Zedekiah, of its branches, which has consumed the vine's fruit, so that it has in it no longer a strong rod to be a scepter for ruling. This is a lamentation, and shall be for a lamentation and a dirge. And in the name of Jesus Christ, this word is already blessed. As we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, are every of us the hearers. And now the New Testament reading, continuing today with the book of Luke chapter 23. And it reads, then the whole multitude of them arose and led him to Pilate. And they began to accuse him, saying, we found this fellow perverting the nation and forbidding to pay taxes to Caesar, saying that he himself is Christ, a king. 3. Then Pilate asked him, saying, are you the king of the Jews? He answered him and said, it is as you say. 4. So Pilate says to the chief priests and the crowd, I find no fault in this man. 5. But they were the same fierce saying. He stirs up the people, teaching throughout all Judea, beginning from Galilee to this place. Verse 6. When Pilate heard of Galilee, he asked if the man were a Galilean. 7. And as soon as he knew that he belonged to Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod, who was also in Jerusalem at that time. 8. Now when Herod saw Jesus, he was exceedingly glad, for he had desired for a long time to see him, because he had heard many things about him, and he hoped to see some miracle done by him. 9. Then he questioned him with many words, but he answered him nothing. Verse 10. And the chief priests and scribes stood and vehemently accused him. Then Herod, verse 11, with his men of war, treated him with contempt and mocked him, arrayed him in a gorgeous robe, and sent him back to Pilate. 12. That very day Pilate and Herod became friends with each other, for previously they had been at enmity with each other. Verse 13. Then Pilate, when he had called together the chief priests, the rulers, and the people, said to them, "You have brought this man to me as one who misleads the people, and indeed, having examined him in your presence, I have found no fault in this man concerning these things of which you accuse him." 15. No, neither did Herod, for I sent him back to him, and indeed nothing deriving of death has been done by him. 16. I will therefore chastise him and release him. 17. For it was necessary for him to release one to them at that feast. 18. And they all cried out at once, saying, "Away with this man, and release to us Barabbas." 19. Who had been thrown into prison for a certain rebellion made in the city, and for murder. 20. Pilate, therefore, wishing to release Jesus, again called out to them. 21. But they shouted, saying, "Crucify him, crucify him." 22. Then he said to them the third time, "Why? What evil has he done? I have found no reason for death in him. I will therefore chastise him and let him go." 23. But they were insistent, demanding with loud voices that he be crucified. And the voices of these men and of the chief priests prevailed. 24. So Pilate gave sentence that it should be as they requested. 25. And he released to them the one they requested, who for rebellion and murder had been thrown into prison. But he delivered Jesus to their will. Verse 26. Now as they led him away, they laid hold of a certain man named Simon, a Cyrenian, who was coming from the country, and on him they laid the cross, that he might bear it after Jesus. 27. And a great multitude of the people followed him, and women who also mourned and lamented him. Verse 28. But Jesus, turning to them, said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children." 29. For indeed the days are coming in which they will say, "Blessed are the barren, wombs that never bore, and breasts which never nursed." 30. Then they will begin to say to the mountains, "Fall on us," and to the hills, "Cover us." 31. For if they do these things in the green wood, what will be done in the dry? 32. There were also two others, criminals, led with him to be put to death. 33. And when they came to the place called Calvary, where they crucified him and the criminals, one on the right hand and the other on the left. 34. Then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." And they divided his garments and cast lots. 35. And the people stood looking on, but even the rulers with them sneered, saying, "He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Christ, the chosen of God." 36. The soldiers also mocked him, coming and offering him sour wine, and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." 38. An inscription was also written over him in letters of Greek, Latin, and Hebrew: "This is the King of the Jews." 39. Then one of the criminals who was hanged blasphemed him, saying, "If you are the Christ, save yourself and us." 40. But the other, answering, rebuked him, saying, "Do you not even fear God, seeing you are under the same condemnation?" 41. And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong. 42. Then he said to Jesus, "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom." 43. And Jesus said to him, "Assuredly, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." 44. Now it was about the sixth hour, and there was darkness over all the earth until the ninth hour. Verse 45. Then the sun was darkened, and the veil of the temple was torn in two. 46. And when Jesus had cried out with a loud voice, he said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." Having said this, he breathed his last. 47. So when the centurion saw what had happened, he glorified God, saying, "Certainly, this was a righteous man." 48. And the whole crowd who came together to the sight, seeing what had been done, beat their breasts and returned. But all his acquaintances and the women who followed him from Galilee stood at a distance, watching these things. Verse 50. Now behold, there was a man named Joseph, a council member, a good and just man. 51. Who had not consented to their decision, and indeed he was from Arimathea, a city of the Jews, who himself was also waiting for the kingdom of God. This man, verse 52, went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. 53. Then he took it down, wrapped it in linen, and laid it in a tomb that was hewn out of the rock, where no one had ever lain before. 54. That day was the preparation, and the Sabbath drew near. 55. And the women who had come with him from Galilee followed after, and they observed the tomb and how his body was laid. Verse 56 and last. Then they returned and prepared spices and fragrant oils, and they rested on the Sabbath according to the commandment. And in the name of Jesus Christ, this word is already blessed as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, or every of us, they hear us. And now our prayer focus, Psalm 36, and it reads, an oracle within my heart concerning the transgression of the wicked. There is no fear of God before his eyes. 2. For he flatters himself in his own eyes, when he finds out his iniquity and when he hates. 3. The words of his mouth are wickedness and deceit. He has ceased to be wise and to do good. 4. He devises wickedness on his bed. He sets himself in a way that is not good. He does not abhor evil. 5. Your mercy, O Lord, is in the heavens. Your faithfulness reaches to the clouds. 6. Your righteousness is like the great mountains. Your judgments are a great deep. O Lord, you preserve man and beast. 7. How precious is your loving kindness, O God. Therefore the children of men put their trust under the shadow of your wings. 8. They are abundantly satisfied with the fullness of your house, and you make them drink from the river of your pleasures. 9. For with you is the fountain of life. In your light we see light. 10. O, continue your loving kindness to those who know you, and your righteousness to the upright in heart. 11. Let not the foot of pride come against me, and let not the hand of the wicked one drive me away. Verse 12 and last. There the workers of iniquity have fallen. They have been cast down and are not able to rise. And in the name of Jesus Christ, this word is already blessed as we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our every of us, they hear us. And let us pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we come before you to say thank you for your mercy, your faithfulness, your righteousness in our lives, the lives of our families, our little ones, our brethren, our pastors, and your holy church. We thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, that your judgments are deep and your mercy preserves us. We thank you, Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, and Holy Ghost, that as we confess our sins, the redemption of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, keeps us and forgives us, Heavenly Father, by his blood, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are hiding nothing from you, and we thank you for cleansing us as we confess of all our unrighteousness in the mighty name of Jesus, according to 1 John 1 and 9. Thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, for your loving kindness over our lives, the grace to be under the shadow of your wings, your secret place where we, our families, our little ones, our brethren, our pastors, our church, and even our city have been saved and are safe in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the gift of the living water, the Holy Spirit, allowing us to drink from the rivers of your pleasures, to live in the abundance that you redeemed for us on the cross at Calvary. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the fountain of life that allows us to see light by your light. O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, our trust is in you. Let not the foot of pride, unbelief, fear, anger, unforgiveness, bitterness, self-pity, judgment, lying, stealing, addiction, or low self-esteem come against us. And let not the hand of the wicked one drive us away from you because of these associations, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father, my helper, my Lord, my Savior, my counselor, my advocate, my healer, my avenger, and my keeper, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, for avenging me, redeeming me, loving me, healing me, and delivering me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. And Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus Christ for Psalm 107, verse 20. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. Thank you, Father, for your word. Thank you for healing by the stripes of Jesus Christ. And we thank you for delivering us from every destructive thing in our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed. Amen, amen, and amen. In Jesus' name.